Today I'm going to walk you through six different ways to convert a column to comma separated list using Excel and other tools. If you have Office 2019 for Mac or Windows or an Office 365 subscription, you're in luck. All you have to do is enter the formula TEXTJOIN into an empty cell. Enter the delimiter. So this is what you want to separate the data by. So in this case, we're going to use a comma. And then I always select true as the next feature, ignore empties. You don't have to. And then you select the range of your data. In this case, A1 through A50, since we are using a list of the 50 states of the United States. Then you just press enter, and voila, you have a comma separated list. You can, of course, change the delimiter to whatever you want. In this case, if I wanted to add a space between, I can do that. Or I can change it to a pipe character. I can use whatever delimiter I want. And all of my data is joined by that delimiter. So as you can see here, all the states are now joined by the pipe character, and there is no extra pipe at the end. The second method requires Excel 2016 or newer, or Excel 365. All you have to do is enter a comma into column B, in this case, and use the formula CONCAT, which combines the two cells A and B, copy and paste that down, and then in your cell where you're trying to merge all of these, again, write CONCAT, select the range of the newly concatenated data. And then now you have a concatenated list separated by commas. Unfortunately, with this method, all of the data will show up comma separated, including the last value. So you will have to remove that extra comma at the very end. Here you can see it after Wyoming. But that's a fairly simple operation. You can also just delete the last cell in column B in order to make it not appear at the end. One final thing to note is if you want to change the delimiter from a comma to anything else, all you have to do is update the cells in column B. The next method is a little bit trickier. I'm going to first go to Capitalize My Titles comma separator tool, which we'll get to in the next section of this video, and scroll down to the section where I have code that you can use to create a module. And you'll see how to create this in Excel. The great thing about this method is it can be used in most versions of Excel, all the way back to Excel 2010 and possibly even Excel 2003. First, you need to make sure that you have developer tab available within Excel. So to do that, go into the options, click on your customize ribbon option, and make sure that the developer box is checked. Once it is, you should see the developer tab show up at the top. Click on view code. And once the screen pops up, you can add a module. So right click on your current workbook, click add module. Now just copy and paste this code. What this does is it creates a custom function or formula within Excel called CSV range, which we can now use within the spreadsheet. All you have to do is type equals CSV range, select the data that you want, and voila, you have a comma separated list. You can change the delimiter that you use by going back to this module and changing comma to whatever you want. If you wanted comma and a space, you can do that. Just go back and rerun the formula, and voila. If you want to save this Excel sheet or workbook afterwards, make sure that you save it as a macro-enabled workbook. Otherwise, you will not be able to run this formula again unless you go back through the same steps that we walked through. The next way to create a comma-separated list is to use our handy comma separator at Capitalize My Title. Find the link in our description. Just copy and paste your list, in this case, a list of the states, into the left text box. And voila, you have a comma separated list that is copied to your clipboard. You can easily change the delimiter from comma to, let's say, pipe or comma and space. And all of these changes are automatically reflected in the right text box. You have a bunch of other features for example, being able to lowercase the list in case you don't want all capitalized letters. You can add quotes around the text. You can add prefixes and suffixes. And our tool just makes it extremely simple. You can even copy and paste a comma-separated list and get a column back. If you use Notepad++, linked in the description of this video, another easy way is to just do a search and replace for new lines. So you can go to replace or press Control H, and then in the Find What box, type in \n for new line, make sure the search mode is extended, and then replace with whatever your delimiter is, in this case, a comma. Once I press replace all, it adds a comma to the beginning of every line. And now I do find what \r, replace with nothing, and then it automatically creates a comma separated list. The final way to create a comma separated list in Excel is exceedingly easy and uses the concatenate function. In the first cell, just type equals and then set the first cell that you want to include. In the next cell, type equals concatenate, then the cell that you created previously, comma, double quote, comma, double quote, and then comma, the cell to the left of this current cell, and press enter. To copy this formula down, find the little black square at the bottom right, double click on it, and now you have all of your cells filled in to the bottom. And the final cell in this column is going to be your comma separated list. Now, just copy and paste the values from this cell using paste values, which is under the home tab in the newer Excel versions. And voila, in the cell that you pasted into, you have the text that is a comma separated list. Paste this to wherever you want. Thank you for watching the video about how to create comma separated lists from a column of data. Like and subscribe for more.